from Apple Valley News Now. First Alert Weather with Chief Meteorologist Josh Colberth.
Good Friday morning. We're still tracking multiple fires within the region, but we have a lot of good news for several of these fires. We'll start in Yakima County. The Williams Mine fire, a little bit of good news with this one is containment jumped from 0% to 2%. Still active hotspots on the map to the south of Mount Adams, and we'll continue to track this one in far southwestern Yakima County. In northern Yakima County with the retreat fire, got some excellent news on this one. First of all, containment went up to 80%. Second of all, even though technically at 6:01 in the morning, there still are level 3 and level 1 evacuations in place, the Yakima County, it was either the sheriff's office or the emergency management for the Yakima Valley. But anyway, they said that these are going to be lifted at 8 this morning. So after 8 o'clock, we won't have to deal with any evacuations from the retreat fire, barring something crazy. Then for the Lone Rock fire, more good news. This thing, remember, it was at 98% containment for like 2 weeks, it felt like. Now it's 100% contained. So we're not going to talk about this fire anymore. That's probably the last time. And then the Battle Mountain Complex, this one consists of two fires, but the heavy lifter is still the Monkey Creek fire, upwards of 180,000 acres. But containment jumped up on this one yesterday as well. Now it's up to 90% contained. We still do have level 2 evacuations in place for portions of Umatilla County and the level 1 evacuations as well. Some of these bleed over into Morrow County too. So good news when it comes to fire. We have even more good news in that some rain is on the way. The bad news is that maybe it's a little bit too much rain. I'll tell you why coming up on Good Morning Northwest, which starts right now.
Straight ahead on Good Morning Northwest, an update on the shooting that injured a person near a Circle K gas station. Police saying a suspect has been arrested. And five people are now charged in connection to actor Matthew Perry's death. Two of them doctors and one of them his assistants. We will have the latest right now. And good morning.
This is Apple Valley News Now. Good morning, Northwest, on your side.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us for Good Morning Northwest. I'm Jessica Jalal.
And I'm Jill Sperling. It is Friday, August 16th, the end of the work week.
End of the work week. Do you have any fun plans this weekend?
I am going to catch up on so much sleep. How about
you? I like the sound of that. Probably just reading, sleeping. I don't know. Sometimes plans become last minute, so you never know.
Yeah,
something could happen.
Yeah.
But we're going to start your top stories now, and we begin with an update to the shooting that injured a juvenile near Circle K gas station in Pasco earlier this week.
The Pasco Police Department says a suspect has been arrested. According to law enforcement, the juvenile suspect was taken into custody at a Richland apartment complex on Wednesday. They're believed to be responsible for the shooting at Chapel Hill Boulevard and Broadmoor Boulevard on Monday.
The victim was taken to a local hospital with a serious gunshot wound to the stomach. The suspect had fled the scene before officers arrived. Police have identified the victim and the suspect as members of rival gangs.
Now to a follow-up on a kidnapping that happened in December of 2021. A 13-year-old girl from Kennewick was communicating through social media with a 36-year-old man in New Mexico.
According to court documents, Lucas Murphy was pretending to be 21 years old. He drove to Kennewick and picked up the girl and took her back to New Mexico.
KPD says they got a report of a runaway, and that's when they got involved. Yesterday, Murphy was sentenced to 20 years in federal prison after pleading guilty to a charge of online enticement of a minor.
As United States attorney and as a parent, these cases involving children strike at the heart of our law enforcement mission. I'm grateful for our partners at the Southeast Regional Internet Crimes Against Children Task Force, and specifically the work of the Kennewick Police Department here, whose dedicated investigations are critical to effective prosecutions that hold those accountable, like Mr. Murphy.
After coordinating with police in New Mexico, the 13-year-old girl was found safe and Murphy was arrested and charged for first-degree kidnapping with sexual motivation, among other charges.
Now, a black bear has been killed in Kittitas County by the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife. On Tuesday night of this week, Fish and Wildlife officers received a report of a human black bear incident in the town of Roslyn.
Officers say an adult male black bear struck a 17-year-old female in the arm, causing scratches and torn clothing. The Kittitas County Sheriff's Office says they quickly located and lethally removed the animal near the scene.
Forensic evidence was collected and the bear will be transported to the Washington Animal Disease Lab. The teen is said to be doing fine.
In education news, we previously told you about the Sunnyside School District's agreement to change its voting system. This from an at-large to a district-based system for school board elections as part of a settlement with Empowering Latina Leadership and Action, or ELLA.
ELLA, represented by the ACLU, filed a notice of intent to sue the district in April, saying its current system dilutes Latinx votes and prevents them from having an equal opportunity to influence the outcome of elections. As part of a settlement, the district has agreed to switch to a system that includes three active majority Latinx voting districts.
It's a huge step for the school district and for their families to finally see, to finally feel seen and heard by the administration and by the school board.
We're now learning the map has been redrawn and will be put before a judge for approval. Per the settlement, it must be in place for the 2025 primary and general elections when all five school board seats are up for election. Well, there was a celebration in Kennewick yesterday, the city hosting a ribbon-cutting ceremony for the newly completed intersection improvements.
The work began last June. Apple Valley News Now's Monique Ledesma explains how the completion of this project will help traffic flow and safety for travelers.
The ribbon-cutting ceremony was to celebrate the Deschutes and Columbia Center Boulevard intersection project. I spoke with the Kennewick Police Department Chief Chris Guerrero, and he says this project was designed to improve traffic and help prevent accidents.
Deschutes and Columbia Center Boulevard here within the city of Kennewick is a high traffic area. We're continually working with our traffic engineers, public works, at looking at opportunities to make our roadways safer. We are always evaluating our high collision areas, and improvements such as this will make the roadways safer.
Deputy City Manager Carrie Rowe says the drivers will be able to tell the difference.
So we improved the efficiency of the intersection from capacity, added turn lanes, put a new signal in.
One of the features added to the project was a roundabout to help traffic flow in the area. As you see right now, it is definitely helping move this traffic. Chief Guerrero says these new additions help support the goal of helping traffic flow and reduce accidents.
Different technologies that come about, right, like these right turn lanes, different roundabouts, people being able to move traffic in a sensible way, which is very easily marked, really helps a ton.
Rowe says another part of the project was widening the intersection to prepare for the next project. Reporting in Kennewick, Monique Ledesma, Apple Valley News Now.
By widening the intersection, the city of Kennewick will now be adding a third lane for northbound and southbound through traffic up to Quinault Avenue.
Coming up next on Good Morning Northwest, the Secret Service says it's planning to put bulletproof glass in front of former President Donald Trump at campaign rallies. This is usually only done for current presidents. We have the details coming up.
And Chief Meteorologist Josh Colbert will have your weather forecast. Good Morning Northwest, we'll be right back.
This summer, turn moments into lifelong memories with Broadmoor RV. Feel the thrill of adventure and the warmth of togetherness. Explore the great outdoors with the comfort of home and let every adventure become a story worth sharing. Broadmoor RV. We make camping fun.
When it comes to legal matters, you need someone you can trust. At Morphine Law Firm, we are sincerely grateful for the last 5 years of trust and support you've given our firm. Your trust and support have been a major driving force behind our mission for justice. We offer free consultations, and we may not always tell you what you want to hear, but we try to steer you in the right direction. We appreciate your continued trust and confidence in Morphine Law Firm.
Hi, I'm Catherine Forner, and we love our own backyard so much, we built all of this. And we get everything we need from PAR. With Shauna's help.
Everything from design to delivery.
PAR, go where the builders go.
What are you gonna build?
Board-certified family medicine provider Dr. Michael Adling is now caring for patients of all ages at Prosser Memorial Health's Benton City Clinic. His services include annual physicals and preventative care, well child exams, the treatment of cold and flu, acute illnesses, and more. To schedule an appointment with Dr. Adling, call the Benton City Clinic at 509-588-4075. Or to learn more about his services, visit prosserhealth.org. This is How We Care.
Welcome to the Walla Walla Airport, where you'll experience enhanced convenience. Your gateway to adventure has expanded its security checkpoint and upgraded the departure area for your comfort. With free parking and daily Alaska Airlines flights to Seattle, your travel plans are easier than ever. Whether you're off to relax or to explore, start your journey smoothly with our improved facilities. Create unforgettable memories today. Book now at alaskaair.com. Your next adventure is just a flight away at Walla Walla Regional Airport, where parking is always free.
The murders of a husband and wife found dead inside their home.
There were wild revelations.
Brandon's secret life.
Now, the powerful prison interview.
Why should we believe you?
2020, tonight on ABC.
Seattle battles Indiana, WNBA Sunday at 12:30, Apple Valley News Now. From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Chief Meteorologist Josh Colberth.
Welcome back to Good Morning Northwest. Most of us just have light smoke or haze up in the sky for this morning. There is some slightly thicker smoke immediately downwind of the Williams mine fire in southern Yakima County, also for Klickitat County. To put this into motion over the next couple days, it's not going to be anything too fantastical. As you see, actually, we could get a decent clearing of some of the smoke for portions of Morrow and Umatilla and maybe even into Benton and Franklin counties as we head into this evening. But watch what happens into tomorrow. The surface winds are going to shift out of the east, and that'll bring a lot of dry air into the region, at least at times. And that'll also bring some much warmer air into the region, which is why we're going to be so much hotter into tomorrow. But of course, a lot of moisture is going to be firing up some thunderstorms potentially into the Cascades, the eastern slopes of the Cascades, but we can't roll out thunderstorms for the basin either. I'm getting a little ahead of myself. That was just intended to talk about the smoke. Temperatures this morning in the 50s and 60s. You might need a very light jacket as you're headed out the front door for this morning. Here's your hour by hour for the rest of today. Highs will still end up being about 5 degrees below average for this time of the year, so expect sunshine. Will be some light hazy sunshine out there, but the temperature should be nice. There is a very small chance for a stray thunderstorm today in the Kittitas Valley or for mountain ranges, but that chance is going to be much more significant into tomorrow, which is why there's a flash flood watch in place for the eastern slopes of the Cascades. So I'll time out these thunderstorm chances. Also, I'll tell you about other threats associated with these chances. That's going to be coming up in a few minutes.
Thank you, Josh. In political news now, the Secret Service says it plans to put bulletproof glass in front of former President Donald Trump at his campaign rallies. This comes after an assassination attempt was made on Trump at a rally in Pennsylvania last month. Bulletproof glass is commonly used for current presidents, and the Defense Department can easily move it from event to event using airplanes, but the Secret Service doesn't have airplanes, so they're planning to store it in various areas around the country where Trump is expected to visit. An official says the Secret Service is also planning to increase the number of agents and implement more technological changes. In more political news, Vice President Kamala Harris is expected to announce plans to lower housing costs. The Democratic presidential nominee will propose the four-year plan during her first economic policy speech in North Carolina today. The plan includes $25,000 in down payment assistance for first-time homeowners. In addition, Harris is expected to call for the construction of 3 million new housing units, including tax incentives for building starter homes. Harris is also expected to announce a federal ban on price gouging to lower the cost of food. Coming up next on Good Morning Northwest, users of X, formerly known as Twitter, are able to create fake pictures through a new AI tool that's created by Elon Musk. How simple it is and why it's a concern is coming up in your business headlines. And as we go to break, we're listening to Birthday by Selena Gomez. Why? Well, because it's almost Josh's birthday. It's tomorrow. And if you're celebrating a birthday today or this weekend, we wish you a happy one right here from Good Morning Northwest. Keep it here. We'll be right back.
Why is the Benton Franklin Fair and Rodeo the best week of summer? Because you get more of what you love about summer. More fun in the sun with thrilling carnival rides and games. More flavors to savor with your favorite tasty fair treats. More world-class entertainment with the summer concert series. And you even get more colorful sunsets as attractions help light up the cotton candy skies. So don't miss out on your best week of summer, August 20th through 24th at the Benton Franklin Fair and Rodeo.
Bath fitter does showers? That's right. We offer a wide selection of beautiful and functional showers in all shapes and sizes. We can even convert your bath into a shower. How about that? With our seamless one-piece walls and hundreds of design options, you'll get a beautiful new shower to fit your needs, guaranteed for life. Bath Fitter's been around for 40 years, and we've been experts at showers for just as long. Get yours today. Bath Fitter, it just fits. Go to bathfitter.com to book your free consultation.
Get 2.9% APR for 36 months plus 1,000 purchase allowance on most 2024 Cadillac models when you finance through Cadillac Financial.
Superstar Martina McBride, the Demolition Derby, the PRCA Rodeo, all part of the 2024 Walla Walla Fair and Frontier Days.
Let freedom ring!
For your chance to win tickets to the fair, scan this QR code or click contest at applevalleynewsnow.com.
Les Schwab Tires reminds you time is running out in Apple Valley News Now's Restaurant Showdown.
Round 5 voting is now open. After voting, enter to win a $25 gift card from STCU. We're giving away a total of 24 cards from STCU, Les Schwab Tires, and Whitman Hill Winery.
Take off on a flight over a magic place filled with cherries and so much more.
It's 35 farmers, about 2,000 acres of fruit trees. And then, of course, an assortment of veggies and berries and you name it.
Fly the Northwest. Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
When you cry, it's for a good reason.
Yeah, or a commercial. Sometimes commercials make me cry.
All right, I wasn't going to bring that up, but okay.
Next Live, Patrick Dempsey.
Today at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
This newscast, sponsored by Mariano Morales Law. From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Chief Meteorologist Josh Colberth.
Welcome back to Good Morning Northwest. Today is going to be mostly dry. We'll have hazy sunshine up in the sky, and we will have a very small chance for a stray thunderstorm up in the Cascades, down in the Blues, or in the Kittitas Valley. But most of us staying dry. Winds today will be a bit breezy, gusting upwards of 20 miles per hour for the Kittitas Valley and for the lower Columbia Basin. For tonight, overnight lows dropping off into the 50s and 60s. Winds dying down. Haze will be pretty light at this point. All right, now we skip ahead to Saturday, and this is when the real weather begins. So we put this into motion. This is Futurecast. It's 5 p.m., 6 p.m. You see that as we start to head into the mid to late evening, that's when this iteration of Futurecast is picking up on a lot of thunderstorm activity on the west side, in the Cascades, also in portions of Yakima and Kittitas County. Now, this model is not indicating thunderstorms for Benton County, Franklin County, Walla Walla, Moro, Umatilla counties, and I think that is being a little too conservative. I think there are some thunderstorm chances that exist this way. It's going to be an interesting setup. We have low-level moisture, but also the surface winds are coming out of the east, which will put some dry air at the very surface level. So, you know, a lot of competing dynamics with this setup, but the National Weather Service in Pendleton has gone with this flash flood watch in place for the eastern slopes of the Cascades in Yakima and Kittitas County. This goes from 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon to 2 in the morning on Sunday, as in and around some of those locally smaller streams and around some of those fresh burn scars, including the retreat fire, that's where we can maybe see some debris flow, some excess runoff, or some localized flooding. So we'll have those thunderstorm chances peaking late Saturday into early on Sunday, and then another peak in the action. It looks like it's possible by Wednesday of next week. We'll track that very closely. By the way, we're always tracking fire start risk around this time of the year when lightning's in the forecast. It'll be pretty hot, by the way, as well for Saturday, but that's just an anomaly. Back down to more seasonal stuff by Sunday. And you can see kind of the breakdown of the thunderstorm chances per zone. Here's a 7-day forecast for the Tri-Cities. Much hotter Saturday with small PM thunderstorm chances. Much cooler again by Sunday and beyond. For Yakima, of course, we'll have that flooding potential in western Yakima County. Lingering thunderstorms possible for Sunday. Another decent chance by Wednesday. For Hermiston, mid-90s with small thunderstorm chances on Saturday. Back into the 80s for Sunday and beyond. Then for Walla Walla, a small afternoon thunderstorm chance as well for Saturday, but less active and less hot for Sunday and into next week.
Thank you, Josh. In your business headlines now, Elon Musk has created an artificial intelligence chatbot called Grok. Earlier this week, it began allowing users to create AI-generated images from text prompts, posting them to X. This tool was created by Musk's AI startup called XAI. Almost immediately, people began using the tool to flood the social media site with fake pictures. Unlike other mainstream AI photo tools, Grok appears to have few guardrails. However, the tool is likely to add to concerns that AI could create too many false or misleading information across the internet. Up next on Good Morning Northwest, five people are now charged in connection to actor Matthew Perry's death. We have the latest on this case coming up. And as we've been mentioning throughout the morning, it is Chief Meteorologist Josh Culbreth's birthday tomorrow. So here's Birthday by Katy Perry. And if you're having a birthday today, we wish you a happy one. We'll be right back.
Ready to bring your dream bathroom to life? At Floor & Home, you dream, we install. This month, pay no sales tax at your local Walla Walla or Tri-Cities Floor & Home.
Warning, your air conditioner unit needs service. Would you like me to call Bruce?
Yes, call Bruce.
Thanks to today's modern technology, it's never been easier to call Bruce Heating and Air. When your AC unit needs serviced, call Bruce.
Oh my gosh.
Let's get this party started.
Just make sure you call the right Bruce.
Now through September 30th, receive rebates up to $1,850 off on a new Daikin Fit system when you finance through Bruce Heating and Air. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Take good care of you, Bruce Heating and Air.
No matter what roads lead you home, McCurley Mazda is about to make your journey even better. Whether it's cruising riverside highways, winding vineyard trails, or anywhere else your travels take you, now is the perfect time to upgrade your way home. Visit McCurley and the Pasco Autoplex today for this special offer.
Find your way home in a new 2024 Mazda with 0% financing from McCurley Mazda.
This Labor Day, More Furniture is introducing the luxurious new Estate Collection of Mattresses by Stearns & Foster. Handmade by certified master craftsmen, the collection features Tempur-Indulge memory foam and IntelliCoil innersprings to provide exceptional comfort and support all night long. During our Labor Day event, take a full 60 months to pay with absolutely no interest and no money down, and get a free premium bedding bundle including two pillows, a mattress protector, and a full set of sheets. Visit your local showroom today.
Dear 2031, we look forward to seeing you. After our 160-point quality assurance inspection, we'll be Toyota certified used vehicles with 7-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranties. Not to honk our own horns, but the best new cars make the best used cars. Yours, Toyota.
Get 6.39% APR for up to 60 months on many of your favorite Toyota certified used models. Find yours at toyotacertified.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Ready to bring your dream bathroom to life? At Floor & Home, you dream, we install. This month, pay no sales tax at your local Walla Walla or Tri-Cities Floor & Home.
Round 5 voting is now open. Click contests at applevalleynewsnow.com.
Welcome back to Good Morning Northwest. In entertainment headlines, the investigation of actor Matthew Perry's death results in charges against five people. Perry died last year after an overdose of ketamine.
The people facing the charges include two doctors, an alleged drug trafficker, and Matthew Perry's assistant. ABC's Rhiannon Alley has the details.
This morning, five suspects are facing federal charges in connection to the overdose death of Friends star Matthew Perry.
These defendants took advantage of Mr. Perry's addiction issues to enrich themselves. They knew what they were doing was wrong.
Last October, Perry was found unconscious in his hot tub. The autopsy revealing he died from acute effects of ketamine. At the time, he had been undergoing ketamine infusion therapy to treat his depression.
When clinic doctors refused to increase his dosage, he turned to unscrupulous doctors who saw Perry as a way to make quick money.
At the center of the case, Dr. Salvatore Placentia, known as Dr. P.
He wrote in a text message in September 2023, quote, "I wonder how much this moron will pay."
Placentia pleading not guilty to charges yesterday. His attorney says his client sold ketamine to Perry, but insists he did not break the law.
He was a patient. He did receive ketamine treatment therapy under medically supervised conditions and in accordance with best medical practices. It was all above board medical treatment.
Prosecutors say Perry later turned to Jasveen Sungha, an alleged drug trafficker known to her customers as the Ketamine Queen, who provided the actor with cheaper ketamine.
She got $11,000 in cash, as opposed to $55,000 in cash.
For the same amount of ketamine?
For a greater amount of ketamine. 50 vials versus 20 vials.
Sungha is also linked to a 2019 overdose death. She has pleaded not guilty to the charges related to Perry's death. Also charged, Perry's live-in personal assistant, Kenneth Iwamasa. Prosecutors say he injected Perry with at least 27 shots of ketamine in the 5 days leading up to his death, including at least three on the day he died, despite not having any medical training. He's pleaded guilty to one count. Perry's family saying it has helped to know law enforcement has taken his case very seriously. We look forward to justice taking its course. Rhiannon Alley, ABC News, New York.
If convicted, both Sungha and Placentia could spend the rest of their lives in prison.
Again, Perry's assistant and two other suspects have pleaded guilty and are facing shorter prison sentences. Up next on Good Morning Northwest, a dog has died after suspected exposure to cyanobacteria in the Columbia River in Oregon. How the Oregon Health Authority is responding and the signs to look out for to keep your pets safe, coming up at 6:30.
And new developments within the Mapton City Council. We have more on the recall petition of the mayor, the second one that's been filed against her. We'll be right back with that.
Make your hard-earned dollars go further during the Labor Day sale at Furniture Row. Shop today, because the more you buy, the more you save. Save $100 on every $1,000 you spend, or get 60 months no interest financing. The Labor Day sale, on now at Furniture Row.
It's a heavy metal blowout as Legends Casino Hotel welcomes the original headbangers, Quiet Riot. Appearing at 8 p.m. on Friday, September 6th, this famous classic rock band from the 80s has rocked venues around the world and is now coming to Toppenish, Washington. Tickets start at just $20 and can be purchased at Ticketmaster.com or the Legends gift shop. Don't miss Quiet Riot and come feel the noise live at Legends Casino Hotel, Friday, September 6th. Get your tickets now.
Phones were made to help us connect, and somehow they've made us less connected.
Which is ironic.
Don't you think? We try to put our phones down, but we need to pick them up to see the menu.
We can't watch something without also watching something else.
Ironic.
Ironic. But look, here's a phone company who wants you to use your phone less.
That's ironic.
Yeah, but in a good way. Let's find us again with Us Mode. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Traffic jam.
Ugh, and I'm already late.
Hey there, are you ready to quackercise? It's the best exercise to get ready for the duck race. I know you guys are ready. Are you? It's coming September 14th. Don't miss your chance to win big at the Mid-Columbia Duck Race. The grand prize is a 2024 Toyota Corolla Cross, plus other fantastic prizes. Support your community, lend a hand, buy a duck, and keep the tradition alive. The Mid-Columbia Duck Race, presented by Toyota and Audubon Auto Care Center.
No one expects to get in a car wreck, but that's exactly what happened last summer. The drunk driver crossed over the center line, crashing into us and causing life-threatening injuries. It was difficult to focus on healing while facing overwhelming medical bills and lost wages. How will our bills get paid? When can I go back to work? So much was running through my head. Abeta Nelson's team did the work to make sure we didn't have to worry.
Abeta Nelson, we focus on you. You focus on healing.
It's time to get moving with a new car from Overturf Kia. The new 2024 Kia Niro gives you three great ways to save fuel. Available with a fuel-efficient gas-electric hybrid, a plug-in hybrid, or as a full electric vehicle. A new 2024 Kia Niro LX gas-electric hybrid starts at just $28,980. Plus, get 4.49% interest for up to 72 months. Overturf Kia at the base of the Blue Bridge in Kennewick.
It's the Labor Day sale at Denver Mattress.
Right now, the more you buy, the more you save. Save $100 on every $1,000 you spend. Check out the Summit Firm for only $299.99 or get 60 months, no interest, and free shipping.
The Labor Day sale, on now at Denver Mattress.
Seattle battles Indiana, WNBA Sunday at 12:30, Apple Valley News Now. This is Apple Valley News Now. Good morning, Northwest, on your side.
Thank you for joining us for Good Morning Northwest. I'm Jessica Jalal.
I'm Jill Sperling.
And I'm Josh Colbert.
Happy early birthday, Josh.
Happy early birthday.
We've already mentioned it.
Thank you.
We think you should put this on for your weather forecast
you
that you're
crown
about to
me
do.
Again?
Yeah.
Crown you the birthday boy.
Ah, thank you.
Good birthday forecast for you? No?
No, because there are thunderstorms in the forecast and there's a risk for flooding, which is why I'm going to take this TR off so we can talk business. We do have some light haze up in the sky for this morning. It's going to be mostly light haze for the rest of today. And then, of course, we will pivot to some of those thunderstorm chances into tomorrow. Right now, temperatures in the 50s and 60s. So I think a lot of us will probably need some sort of light jacket for this morning. But a little bit later today, we're going to have another day where we'll be up into the 80s. Which will place us at about 5 degrees below average for this time of the year. Hazy sunshine out there, and there will be a very small chance of a shower or thunderstorm for our mountain ranges or for the Kittitas Valley. However, those chances will resurge in a big way into Saturday. Much more significant thunderstorm chances for late tomorrow into the wee hours of the morning on Sunday. Again, we touch on the light haze, and temperatures will be going way up for tomorrow, but then after tomorrow, the cooler weather that we've been getting accustomed to will continue. So tomorrow's just going to sort of be an anomaly. And I'll show you the thunderstorm chances for tomorrow. I'll show you the fire start potential for tomorrow. We'll touch on the flooding potential as well. All that's going to be coming up in a few minutes.
Thank you, Josh. And we start this half hour off in the city of Mapton, where the upheaval is continuing. The city council at odds with the mayor over budget concerns and the petition they filed with the courts to recall her.
Council members say the mayor has repeatedly denied them access to the city attorney. And on Tuesday, council voted to approve a contract with a new attorney, which the mayor refused to sign. Then a judge ruled their recall petition could move forward based on her failure to adopt a 2024 budget and allegedly using her position as mayor to secure special privileges by using the city's website to advertise her personal business.
Now we've learned there is a second petition spearheaded by a resident.
The reason for that was because I feel like she's doing some things that are a little bit illegal.
A hearing on the second recall petition has been set for August 27th in Yakima County Superior Court.
A toxic algae is believed to have led to the death of a family pet in Oregon.
According to the dog's owner, the border collie was playing in the Columbia River near Sand Island, east of Portland, on August 4th. The dog became ill and was taken to the nearest emergency vet, but did not survive.
The Oregon Health Authority says there's currently no active advisories for cyanobacteria on the Columbia River, but that doesn't mean it's not there.
Because we don't monitor all of Oregon's water bodies for cyanobacteria or cyanotoxins, our best recommendation is that folks become familiar with their surroundings and know the signs of a bloom before they take a plunge into the water.
So here's what to look out for. Water that's foamy or scummy or has pea green or blue green mats or even bright green globs.
The Oregon Health Authority is now testing part of the Columbia River for toxic algae blooms. Looking ahead now to some big events happening across the region, the Hermiston Melon Fest is back this weekend.
On Saturday, there's a full day of family-friendly fun celebrating the Pacific Northwest's iconic watermelons, or as I like to say, watermelons. Melon Fest is happening on Main Street and Festival Street from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., and the roads will be closed down there starting at 3 p.m. today.
Organizers say there are three main watermelon producers in the area, which means there is a lot of fruit.
17 truckloads a day from just one supplier. So, I mean, they're going out everywhere. And so a lot of watermelons come out of Hermiston.
Hermiston just has a very good reputation for raising the sweetest, juiciest watermelons in the state of Oregon.
So there is free watermelon, musical performances, around 58 vendors, and contests and activities throughout the day.
And here are the events happening on Saturday. At 10:30 is the watermelon costume contest. 11 a.m. is the watermelon seed spitting contest. Noon is the watermelon eating contest. And at 1 p.m., the watermelon bathtub races. Again, this is Saturday from 9 to 2 p.m.
Up next on Good Morning Northwest, the Toyota Center hosted its first ever Zamboni training and service seminar yesterday. We have a look at it when we come back. But first, Josh will have what you can expect in your weather forecast. That's in a few minutes.
Good Morning Northwest streams all day at applevalleynewsnow.com and our mobile apps.
Power your adventures with the all-electric 2024 Subaru Solterra. It comes with legendary Subaru symmetrical all-wheel drive, standard. Plus a rugged 8.3 inches of ground clearance. Everything about the Subaru Solterra is advanced, including the technology keeping you and your passengers safe. Love is now electric.
Find your way home in a new Subaru Solterra from McCurley Subaru during the Subaru A Lot to Love event.
Board-certified psychiatric nurse practitioner Stephen Stokes provides mental health care for patients 13 and older at Prosser Memorial Health's Benton City Clinic. His services include the assessment and treatment for mental health issues and psychiatric medication management. Your mental health is vital to your overall well-being. To schedule an appointment with Stephen Stokes, call the Benton City Clinic at 509-588-4075. This is how we care.
It's time for Columbia Basin Buildings and Shed's summertime sales event. Discover our wide variety of buildings, including custom build options to fit your unique needs, and they are all on sale. Minimum of 10% off all buildings. That's right. We offer free and fast delivery, and we're committed to unbeatable quality and service. Don't miss out on the best deals of the season. Come visit Columbia Basin Building and Sheds in West Richland and Sunnyside for the best deals of the season.
When it comes to legal matters, you need someone you can trust. At Morphine Law Firm, we are sincerely grateful for the last 5 years of trust and support you've given our firm. Your trust and support have been a major driving force behind our mission for justice. We offer free consultations, and we may not always tell you what you want to hear, but we try to steer you in the right direction. We appreciate your continued trust and confidence in Morphine Law Firm.
Exmark mowers were born to deliver legendary reliability, signature cut quality, and stubborn durability that refuses to give in. Because like you, Exmark mowers were built for this. Save big on Exmark Vertex mowers. Take advantage of instant rebates and bonus fleet discounts for a limited time only.
Experience the difference. Liberty Lawn and Saw on Van Giesen in West Richland.
Take off on a flight over a magic place filled with cherries and so much more.
It's 35 farmers, about 2,000 acres of fruit trees. And then, of course, an assortment of veggies and berries and you name it.
Fly the Northwest. Apple Valley News Now at 6 Tuesday.
When you cry, it's for a good reason.
Yeah, or commercials. Sometimes commercials make me cry.
All right, I wasn't going to bring that up, but okay.
Next Live, Patrick Dempsey. Today at 9 on Apple Valley News Now.
From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Chief Meteorologist Josh Colberth.
Welcome back to Good Morning Northwest. Another look at temperatures for this morning as we are in the 50s and 60s. And there are some light breezes out there for this morning. So I'm thinking a lot of us would want that light jacket. But later today, we're going to end up being in the 80s for most spots. So it's going to be another day where it will be about 5 degrees below average for this time of the year. But this time of the year is mid-August, so it's still going to be pretty warm out there. Okay, pivoting to Saturday, specifically into Saturday afternoon and into early Sunday morning. Here's some of the thunderstorm chances for that time frame. And we are not ruling out thunderstorms for the Tri-Cities or for the foothills of the Blues, but easily the best chances are going to be in Yakima County, Kittitas County, and up into the Cascades. Here's the time frame we're thinking, a little bit more of an expanded time frame for Kittitas County, 2 p.m. on Saturday to 5 in the morning on Sunday. But for the rest of these locations, it's going to be 2 p.m. to 2 a.m. Saturday to Sunday. And here is what the vegetation is looking like for tomorrow with all the lightning in the forecast. Remember, the 100th percentile would be the driest vegetation on record. So we're going to be into the 72nd percentile for Kittitas and Yakima counties, into the 74th percentile for the lower Columbia Basin. And the best chance of fire starts for tomorrow is going to be in the Blue Mountains. At least that's where the vegetation is going to be the driest. But where we'll have the most amount of thunderstorms and in turn the most amount of water, that's going to be in the eastern slopes of the Cascades. That's why we have a flash flood watch that's in place again from 2 p.m. to 2 a.m. Saturday to Sunday. I'll tell you about some of the other risks that exist for tomorrow with this thunderstorm chance, and that's going to be coming up in a few minutes.
Thank you, Josh. Check this out now. The Toyota Center hosted its first ever Zamboni training and service seminar yesterday.
Apple Valley News Now's Lucy Lobdell was there to learn all about what it takes to clean and smooth a sheet of ice.
Zamboni, a well-recognized name in the world of ice rinks. It's a brand name for this big machine that conditions the ice into a smooth surface.
There's a blade inside the conditioner in the back. It shaves the top layer of ice, and it's laying a new layer of ice as well. So you're both cutting and putting a new layer on there at the same time.
The Toyota Center is hosting its first annual Zamboni training and service seminar, a day and a half with 16 attendees from 8 arenas.
We want to get everybody on the same page to make sure that we have consistent ice everywhere, consistently across the country, but really specifically up here in the Pacific Northwest.
Hockey and other ice-dependent activities are growing in the PNW. This event aims to provide information and discussion about maintenance and operation in order to keep up.
Greasing a chain, making sure you hit those different points, regular blade changes, just like your car as far as an oil change and things of that sort.
Making perfect ice requires knowledge and skill. Just a couple inches of ice takes about 4 days to build up with these big machines.
A lot of people have retired in this industry. A lot of things have changed in this business. And to get that consistent standard, we need to get people up to speed.
Hockey teams, local clubs, and evening skaters enjoy the ice at the Toyota Arena. And it all depends on these machines.
It's fun, right? Everybody gets excited to see the Zamboni, whether you're a little kid or a big kid. It's the most expensive car I've ever driven. It only goes 9 miles an hour.
Lucy Lobdell, Apple Valley News Now.
Coming up next on Good Morning Northwest, Chief Meteorologist Josh Culbreth has your first alert full weather forecast.
And still ahead are all of your top stories in your 6 o'clock morning sprint. We'll be right back.
No matter what roads lead you home, McCurley Mazda is about to make your journey even better. Whether it's cruising riverside highways, winding vineyard trails, or anywhere else your travels take you, now is the perfect time to upgrade your way home. Visit McCurley and the Pasco Autoplex today for this special offer.
Find your way home in a new 2024 Mazda with 0% financing from McCurley Mazda.
Downtown Summer Nights 2024, presented by Yakima Federal Savings and Loans. Mark your calendar for the last three Thursdays of June, July, and August. Join us at our new location, 15 West Yakima Avenue. It's time to make this summer the best one yet. Live music, local artists, and delicious food await. Bring the whole family for a night of fun and festivities, and for our guests over 21, don't miss out on our exclusive beer garden. Enjoy the best cocktails, wine, beer, and cider the Valley has to offer. For more details, visit downtownyakima.com.
I have two options for you to take a look at.
When it's time for an update or a complete remodel.
Just watch yourself there. So here, guys, we're going to rip everything down to the studs.
Rebath is with you every step of the way, from design and products to removal and installation.
Okay, what do you guys think?
We handle the entire process to create a beautiful and functional bathroom for whatever your life needs. Rebath, with you every step of the way. Call us or visit rebath.com and save $1,000 off your complete bathroom remodel.
Struggling with persistent pain? Board-certified physiatrist Dr. Ralph Larezo is now caring for patients at Prosser Memorial Health's Prosser Clinic. Dr. Larezo brings over 30 years' experience in physical medicine and rehabilitation, specializing in the management and treatment of acute and chronic pain conditions. Start a new path in restoring your quality of life and ask your primary care provider about making a referral to see Dr. Larezo. This is how we care.
The Make It Ford summer sales event is on. Amazing offers and a great selection of the best-selling trucks in America for 47 years. Ford F-Series, gas, hybrid, or all electric. These are the deals you've been waiting for, so don't wait. Make It Ford.
Ford. Make it yours. Make it now. Lease a 2024 F-150 STX for just $399 a month or get 0 for 36 and $3,700 bonus cash only at your local Ford dealer.
Les Schwab Tires reminds you time is running out in Apple Valley News Now's Restaurant Showdown.
Round 5 voting is now open. After voting, enter to win a $25 gift card from STCU. We're giving away a total of 24 cards from STCU, Les Schwab Tires, and Whitman Hill Winery.
The murders of a husband and wife found dead inside their home.
There were wild revelations.
Brandon's secret life.
Now, the powerful prison interview.
Why should we believe you?
2020, tonight on ABC.
Seattle battles Indiana, WNBA Sunday at 12:30, Apple Valley News Now. From Apple Valley News Now, First Alert Weather with Chief Meteorologist Josh Colberth.
Welcome back to Good Morning Northwest. Today is going to be a nice day, and that will have plenty of sunshine up in the sky. We're going to be about 5 degrees below average for this time of the year, and the breezes will only be slight, gusting upwards of 20 miles per hour for the Kittitas Valley, and it's going to be at the same rate for the lower Columbia Basin. Then for tonight, the winds calm down. Overnight lows dropping off into the 50s and 60s. Pretty comfortable out there. And we'll continue to have some pretty light haze in the forecast. All right, now let's get down to the nitty gritty of this forecast as we transition into Saturday. Here's Futurecast, and I want you to pay attention to the timing up here. And there are chances for thunderstorms starting around 2 o'clock and moving forward, but this particular iteration of Futurecast is really honing in on some thunderstorm chances, especially in Yakima and Kittitas County into the late evening on Saturday into the wee hours of the morning on Sunday. This iteration of Futurecast didn't show a lot of activity for the lower Columbia Basin, for the foothills of the Blues, for the Blue Mountains, but just know there is certainly a very tangible chance for showers and thunderstorms there tomorrow as well. But obviously the biggest threat lies in the Cascades, also in the eastern slopes of the Cascades. That's why the National Weather Service in Pendleton has gone with this flash flood watch. So we'll watch for the potential of debris flows and excess runoff, especially in and around some of those fresh burn scars, like with the retreat fire and around some of the smaller streams up that way. Also, there's a very small chance of some quarter-sized hail and some very gusty winds for tomorrow. So we'll keep tabs on that as well. Into next week, the next big thunderstorm day looks like it's going to be on Wednesday, so we'll also track the fire start potential, just like we'll track the fire start potential with tomorrow as well. High temperatures, very anomalous for tomorrow, up around 100, but back down to more seasonal values in the Tri-Cities for Sunday and beyond. Here's the 7-day forecast for the Tri-Cities. Much hotter on Saturday with some small PM thunderstorm chances, much cooler again by Sunday and beyond. For Yakima, we'll have that flooding potential in western Yakima County, obviously, and some lingering thunderstorms possible for Sunday, another decent chance by Wednesday. For Hermiston, mid-90s with small thunderstorm chances on Saturday, back into the 80s for Sunday and beyond. And then for Walla Walla, we'll also have that small afternoon and evening thunderstorm chance for Saturday, less active and less hot for Sunday and into next week. Now let's head out to New York City to see what's coming up on GMA.
In this morning's GMA First Look, a real estate game changer.
Everybody is going to be better off, and there will be transparency added to what is typically the largest single financial transaction of a person's life.
Under new rules that take effect nationwide Saturday, if you're a buyer, you'll have to sign a written contract with your realtor spelling out their compensation before you go on your first home tour.
Do you have any expectation on what the typical commission might be going forward?
If you're asking me about my crystal ball, right? The crystal ball that I say, there's going to be a little bit of a learning curve for both the real estate professionals and the consumer. And so I think rather quickly we'll see the dust settle, and you know we'll get into what the new normal is.
And coming up at 7 a.m., whether you're buying, selling, or on the fence, we'll tell you what these new real estate changes mean for you. With your GMA First Look, I'm Elizabeth Schulze, ABC News, New York.
When you have moderate to severe eczema, it's okay to show off. With Dupixent, show off your clearer skin and less itch. Because you have plenty of reasons to show off your skin. With Dupixent, the number one prescribed biologic by dermatologists and allergists, you can stay ahead of your eczema. It helps block a key source of inflammation inside the body that can cause eczema to help heal your skin from within. many adults saw 90% clearer skin. Some even achieved long-lasting clearer skin and fast itch relief after first dose. Serious allergic reactions can occur that can be severe. Tell your doctor about new or worsening eye problems, such as eye pain or vision changes, including blurred vision, joint aches and pain, or a parasitic infection. Don't change or stop asthma medicines without talking to your doctor. Show off to the world. Ask your eczema specialist about Dupixent.
Now, the morning sprint.
It's now 6:50. It's time for your 6 o'clock morning sprint. We start off in your national headlines with news on the Democratic National Convention.
It's set to begin in Chicago on August 19th, which is Monday. Chicago continues to prepare for the DNC with security preparations, including things like fencing and parking restrictions. During a press conference with the United States Secret Service, Chicago city officials said the city is ready to host the convention.
The Secret Service is planning to put bulletproof glass in front of former President Donald Trump at campaign rallies. This comes after an assassination attempt was made on Trump at a rally in Pennsylvania last month.
The Defense Department uses this for current presidents and can easily move it from event to event using airplanes, but the Secret Service does not have planes, so they're planning to store it in various areas around the country where Trump is expected to visit.
In your business headlines, retail sales surged unexpectedly across the U.S. in July, according to the Department of Commerce. They rose by a solid 1% from the month before, which exceeded expectations of a 0.3% gain. Retail sales, which are adjusted for seasonal swings but not inflation, make up a sizable chunk of overall spending.
July's reading is good news because the country's economic growth relies on Americans spending their money. This comes after several economic hurdles Americans have been facing.
Some homeowners are rushing to refinance their mortgages now that rates have dropped. This week, the standard 30-year fixed rate mortgage averaged 6.49%.
That was up slightly from the prior week. Last week, mortgage applications surged, driven by homeowners seeking to refinance. Mortgage rates are expected to drop even further this year, but it's unclear if they'll fall below 6%.
In your health headlines now, prices are dropping on 10 Medicare drugs related to diabetes, heart failure, and cancer. The Biden administration says the new prices will save the federal government $6 billion and seniors $1.5 billion.
Those figures don't factor in some existing rebates and discounts, so the final numbers could be lower. Drug companies are suing, and experts have varying opinions. The costs are set to come down in 2026.
The FDA has proposed guidelines to help Americans consume less sodium by lowering the sodium levels in processed foods.
The guidelines could help cut average daily sodium intake by about 20%. The agency says a large percentage of the sodium Americans consume is commercially processed, packaged, and prepared.
And in some sports headlines, the next head coach of the U.S. men's national soccer team will be Argentina's head coach, Mauricio Pochettino. He would replace the previous head coach, Greg Berhalter, who was fired following a disappointing Copa America exit in July.
The 52-year-old head coach most recently managed Chelsea in the English Premier League and guided the club to a sixth-place finish last season, among other achievements. He'll be guiding the U.S. team at a World Cup on home soil in 2026.
U.S. gymnast Jordan Chiles was stripped of her bronze medal at the Paris Olympics after the Court of Arbitration said Romania's Ana Barboso was the rightful winner. Olympic officials say they did not receive crucial emails related to appealing Chiles' case until it was too late to submit objections,
saying therefore they were not able to properly prepare for the hearing. However, U.S. Olympic officials say they will continue to appeal the matter, and Chiles says the decision is unjust.
The home of the Indiana Fever and Caitlin Clark will host the 2025 WNBA All-Star Game. The league announced that the game will take place in Indianapolis on July 19th next year.
ESPN says the 2024 WNBA All-Star Game was the most watched WNBA All-Star Game ever. That was over 300% more than the year before. Now, here are the 5 local stories you need to know this morning. Starting off, a suspect has been arrested in Monday night's shooting on Chapel Hill and Broadmoor Boulevard in Pasco that seriously injured a juvenile. The suspect, also a juvenile, was taken into custody at a Richland apartment complex on Wednesday. Police have identified the victim and the suspect as members of rival gangs.
A man has been sentenced to 20 years in federal prison for enticing a minor online. According to court documents, in 2021, 36-year-old Lucas Murphy pretended to be 21 years old while talking to a 13-year-old Kennewick girl online. He drove to Kennewick, picked up the girl, and took her back to New Mexico. Murphy pleaded guilty to one count of online enticement of a minor.
The city of Kennewick is celebrating the completion of the Deschutes and Columbia Center Boulevard intersection project. One of the improvements was a new roundabout. Kennewick's police chief says the roundabout and other changes, like right turn lanes, help improve traffic flow and prevent collisions.
A call for employers, registration to be part of a career fair at WSU Tri-Cities on October 22nd are now open. The deadline to apply is October 1st. Employers will have the opportunity to meet with students from all majors and class standings. Last year, the career fair hosted 60 employers and more than 190 students, and they're looking to increase the numbers this year.
The second annual Felines and Firefighters Adoption Event is happening at the Tri-Cities Animal Shelter today. Between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m., people can meet a variety of cats and kittens looking for a home and talk to firefighters from the Pasco Fire Department. If you're more of a dog person, you're still encouraged to show up because there are plenty of canines available for adoption as well. All right, check this out now. It's a special day on Good Morning Northwest because it is Josh's birthday, not today, but tomorrow.
Happy early birthday. Yeah. I thought this would make noise. I'm a little disappointed.
They never make noise.
Oh,
some of them do.
Yeah.
And we have a cake for you if you want to bring that over.
Goodness.
We're gonna do like ice cream cake, right?
Yes, and I love cookies and cream as well.
Oh, so when you said that, I'm like, I don't know if it's ice cream cake, but it's cookies and cream.
A double win. Thank you so much.
Go ahead and cut it. And what are you wishing for? You're not supposed to tell anyone.
No, you can tell
anyone.
You can tell.
Yeah. Well, like I said during the 5 o'clock hour, I just want to grow more. Like I just don't want to stop growing. So.
Now, what's the real answer? $1 million? Just kidding.
Well, everyone wants that. Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
I'm getting a little stage fright trying to cut the cake.
I know. It's always weird when someone's singing happy birthday.
Yeah. Well, thank you all so much, and thank you for pulling out all the stops for my birthday.
Of
I really
course.
Do appreciate it. Makes me feel really
happy
special.
Happy birthday. We
okay.
Must.
Temperatures this morning, 50s and 60s, so you might need a light jacket as you're headed out the front door. A little bit later today, we'll be in the 80s, mostly light haze out there, plenty of sunshine. Stray chance of a shower for the Kittitas Valley, also for our mountain ranges. And then into tomorrow, the chances go way up, especially for Yakima and Kittitas County. But don't sleep on the thunderstorm chances for the basin or for the foothills. But we will have the highest concentration of rainfall potentially for the eastern slope of the Cascades. So that's why that flash flood watch is in place.
Thank you, Josh. And thank you guys for watching Good Morning Northwest. You can always find the latest updates on our website.
Good Morning America is up next, and we'll be back with your local news and weather tonight at 5. Have a great day.